go to some movement. So if you are an advanced pianist, you would want to train yourself to imagine, of course, every note in the chord, because obviously that will help to control the touch much better. All three notes in every chord should be evenly imagined in your imagination. Now, if you're not that advanced, then you can just imagine one note, maybe two. And if you choose one note, then I suggest to just imagine the one that is in your thumb. All right, so about the movements. No, let's talk about imagination. Again, you can use strings, you can use cellos, you can use violins, you can use soprano, you can use sound texture. Whatever you might find easier for you to imagine. So just let me just put it here. I know I've said it, but since it's related. So if you want to imagine all three notes in the chord, you can't, let's say, then just use this exercise in your imagination, not playing, not singing. You would imagine notes to the right. I mean, it depends on the chord, right or left. So the first chord I take to the right. So you reduce time, and in this case it's easier to imagine all notes together. All right, now let's go to movements. So movements will help, movements in your imagination, movements in your wrist will help with cohesiveness. And now this movement that you're gonna make, quite bold at the beginning, will be drastically decreased in the process of practicing. Again, I've said it many times that every movement that we make in the beginning is just for establishing good inner sensations, good intonation, because intonation contains this sound movement that you imagine. Without sound movement, there is no intonation. But when your intonation starts having the nuances of harmony, dynamics, musical speech phrasing, image and form, it will affect the length of the movement in singing, and your singing will affect your hand movements. So when you notice, when I play, I'm not playing this way. Because in this case, my intonation would be quite, you know, sloppy, I don't know how to explain, would be not in a style, I would say. So when my intonation would have the colors of harmony, the dynamics, the expression of musical speech, which interval I intonate, you know, and here I'm not intonating like octaves, it's a quite stiff intervals here. The phrasing again, the energy in the phrasing. The image of the piece, you know, it's not very like a happy piece. There's some grief and sadness and despair in it. So everything a little bit more tight, and that would affect my intonation. So the length of the movement in my intonation is less, but it's still there. You can see it's still a little bit there. From outside you can see, so I still feel it. Now what is also important, so after you imagine, you know, you played with good wrist movement, then you have to release tension in hands right after playing a chord. So don't hold it, you know, especially when your elbow is like this also. So don't hold the tension in your hand after pressing the key, otherwise it will prevent your fingers actually from moving down to the keys when your wrist is gonna be too stiff. So you take the chord and you release tension. And you release tension. And you release tension. Because you know, I think when I play some now, I feel that if you don't release, then you know, to be able to prepare next chord, really prepare, it requires a lot of amount of tension over here. So you have to have a room to start tense, you know, because if you play the chord and your hand is still tense, then it's like you cannot breathe anymore, you know, you can tense more from the point where you already tense. So you have to give yourself a little bit of room. And now you can inhale again and tense and relax again. Prepare and tense and relax again. At least in the first steps, it's very, very important. Now let's talk about imagination back. Imagining long notes and tight notes in your right hand long enough will help later with a good balance between hands. So we all know melody, you know, should be much higher than the left hand, than accompaniment. Playing it loud, just loud, is not enough. You have to, again, with your ears, prolong this sound in your imagination. Means that when I imagine, I'm not imagining, it will sound this way. And then I'm thinking about left hand. Right hand again. Show up right away in this case. Now, if you imagine, then left hand will be always under what you have imagined. Imagining, okay, so it's on the same. It's, you know, 15 years old keyboard Yamaha for like $100. It sounds beautiful because it still gives the illusion that the sound is flowing, because my left hand is extremely, extremely soft in this case. So even in a dead piano like this, the sound can still flow. And the last one, imagining the rest, you know, the last rest, as a silence will make you feel very comfortable and natural in this part. So again, said many times before, the rest is not the absence of music, at least in your mind. Simply use the rest as the sound of the silence. So when you come to this chord and then this rest, continue it. And imagining rest, it could be very, very beautiful and satisfying, I must say. Imagining this silence. You see? So, in this part, it's really like a waiting and listening for an answer, because this is like a questioned chord. Waiting for an answer in the silence. And that also brings some more meaning to the image of music. So if you play with imagination, with movements, with, let's say, pedals, so it would look just like this. And of course you move your elbow on circle notes. Only on imagining the sound. I'm not making any dynamics, any harmony, any voicing here. I'm not trying to play with expressiveness. It's very important. We have to always filter the steps, because we all have a habit to trying to make right away everything that we see in this chord, even though sometimes we don't even see everything.